What's happening, folks? Back with another ABBA reaction.
And indeed, we're going back to 1980 Super Trooper. I did want to mention, I was very keen and excited to read that a number of people mention the synths start playing a bigger role at this point, becomes more a part of their production. And although I did hear some differing opinions, it does seem that even among people who might prefer one or two of the previous albums, this really is a special album, and it's sort of, I think someone mentioned it, it's like peak production when it comes to ABBA, so looking forward to it. I do want to mention the further two albums, the one that came out, I think, a year after this, and then one that came out much later and somewhat recently. We're going to go through everything. So once more, shout out to Adam for sharing it all. And the next tune on the 1980 album, Super Trooper, which again, shout out to all the people who pointed out to me, this is a term that's used for the main stage light, and you know, the song being about being in that light for a long time and what it can do to you and the pressures and the stresses and so on. But the next tune is called The Winner Takes It All. And if I'm remembering this correctly, someone mentioned that this is a tune written by Bjorn and sung by Agnetha, and it's essentially about a relationship that doesn't exist anymore, and that it's in the wake of their own divorce. So yeah, it's interesting. As I mentioned, I think in the last reaction for Super Trooper, I'm really impressed when a group that maybe has had a situation on a personal level that's gone into a place that's not as ideal as it was before, but they recognize the artistic power of what they are as a unit and continue to make music. So, and you know, it feels like that's most obvious or notable when we're talking about marriages or people that had intimate relationships and are no longer together. So, yeah, and it's interesting to write a song about that experience and then to have it be sung by your former partner. It's just this really interesting you know, quirk of history and personal connections. So like I said, shout out to them for continuing even after their personal lives had gone into a different place than they were before. And the idea of the winner takes it all, you know, it speaks to an uneven or asymmetrical outcome following the cessation of a relationship. So whether that, you know, is seen specifically in the light of a former romantic relationship, or whether it's, you know, just the connection that you had with someone, and then because of the way things played out, someone seems to get all of the positive that might remain or be possible after the relationship, while the other person gets, if anything, something far less valuable, or maybe nothing at all. So yeah, it speaks to a winner-take-all situation, but not knowing a whole lot about their personal lives other than the fact that they were married and at this point they are no longer, and there's been a couple songs, I think, that have can be seen in that light. As far as I know, this one might be the most direct, given what someone said about it. So, in any case, I'm looking forward to this one. Let's find out what it is. This is ABBA. The tune is The Winner Takes It All, and it's from the 1980 album Super Trooper.
Building me a home.
Job of capturing that complicated feeling. You've been with someone, they've been important to you, things didn't work out, you still have some residual emotional attachment, but you recognize that, you know, this is something that you just have to work through, and you know, maybe things weren't quite as they seemed. You thought you belonged there in their arms, but as it turns out, you know, you were just traveling together for a while in that regard. So there's a lot of emotion in the song that I think is well captured by the complicated sonics. It was a sad sounding song, but it also had, it had vivacity, it had life, and it had her amazing vocals, especially when she really pushes it. I mean, she can go from soft and tender to full-born like Valkyrie like in a moment. It's just amazing the way she can really jump back and forth between powerful and belting and more, again, soft and tender. And yeah, there's like a number of lines along the way. I didn't catch everything, but I did catch a lot of them, and I feel like they're the kind of lines that if you've been through a complicated relationship, if you've had those feelings after a relationship where it feels like maybe things didn't play out in a fair way for you, you know, you got to get over it, but you still, you know, like, it's complicated how I feel toward you. So people who've been in situations like that, and I've gone through feelings like that where it felt like maybe it didn't play out the way it should have, but, you know, I recognize that that's life, that's reality, those are things everybody goes through. And it's not so simple as like, well, I'm just going to walk away from this and not think about you anymore, and that's it. It's more complicated. So I enjoy the way the title phrase was used. I enjoy the complicated emotion of the tune, and her vocals are just, you know, on another planet. So what a really interesting song in their history, in their the evolution of their sound. Another one that sounds fantastic. Again, as we go through this album, I'll be on the lookout for not only hallmarks that I've come to associate with their music, but also little tidbits that may be, you know, expanded or crystallized. And again, people mentioned after I commented on the synth bass in the previous track that synth sounds will play a much bigger role. So just keen to go through this whole album. Really appreciate the ABBA people.
again, there's been a couple times where I wasn't necessarily going to do an ABBA reaction, but the enthusiasm and support from the ABBA fans is just sort of driving me on to make me keep going through the catalog. So indeed, a couple people are like, you are going to go through everything, right? I want to assure you here on camera, I am going to go through everything. And once more, let's all give a big shout out to Adam for sharing all this stuff. And, you know, they're high quality files, they're flak rip. So yeah, basically really appreciate the benefactor of this, or proprietor, I should say, of this deep dive. All right, Luca, at this point, I do have to pick you up. I do apologize. But yeah, you let me know what you think of this one, and Luca and I will see you next time. Peace.